Hello everyone, what you are watching right now is a 6K 360 video shot on an ARRI Alexa Mini LF in open gate with the Entaniya HAL 220. Kitty is sitting very uncomfortably about 4 feet away from the camera. I forced her again to be the model and she's not so happy about it. Now our director John instructs her to walk away and walk back into the camera to do a narrative film style distance test. She's now standing 2.5 to 3 feet away from the camera, which is really close in VR. If you look down right now, her feet are under the tripod. If you are making films in VR, you want to get the subject as close to the camera as possible to create that emotional impact. One of the common issues in VR film is that the subject always feels so far away. With Alexa Mini LF and Entaniya fisheye lens, we are trying to solve this limitation and push narrative VR filmmaking to the next level. You won't see this close-up impact unless you are watching this with your VR headset like the Oculus Quest 2 on YouTube VR. So save this video on your watch later playlist. Download the YouTube VR app on your Oculus Quest 2 and watch it there. It should show up on your watch later playlist on your YouTube VR. The best way to see it though is to silo the full 6K video onto Oculus Quest 2. No YouTube compression get in the way, so you can see the full Hollywood level image quality of the Alexa Mini LF in VR. If you are a member of my new 360 VR filmmaking masterclass, you can download the original fisheye RAW ARRI MXF file, the ProRes 422 HQ stitched version, and the Oculus Quest 2 sideloaded version. I will provide all the link in this video description down below. If you are a professional DP or director looking for a cinematic way to film VR content, I highly recommend downloading them and see them yourself. Now we see some fast motion. Kitty is doing a jumping jack. Now Kitty is doing the Macarena dance. Wow, I don't even know she can dance. To capture 6K 360 video, we need to shoot at open gate in 29.97fps. Single lens resolution is 4480 by 3096. We wish we can shoot at 60 frames per second, which is more ideal for VR. ARRI might release a new camera in spring 2022, which will do 6K open gate in 60 frames per second. That camera will be even better for 360 VR film. Don't forget to subscribe to Creator Up. We will do our best to get our hand on the latest ARRI camera to do tests on live action VR production. Now we are doing some nodal stitching tests. The lens we use is Entaniya HAL 220PL. It's a PL mount lens with 220 degree edge to edge sharpness. Kitty is standing more than 180 degree now on your right. The stitching is still really good. This is all thanks to the wide coverage of the HAL 220. Now she's moving on to your left, more than 200 degrees behind the lens. Now you do see some mystical VR optical flow stitching artifacts. We will teach you how to fix that easily with edge point within mystical VR in our new lesson from my 360 VR filmmaking masterclass. So now, let's talk about why we should Nodal 360 with ARRI Alexa Mini LF. And what is Nodal 360? Nodal 360 is to first shoot 180 or 3D 180 with a fisheye lens like the Entaniya HAL 220 or HAL 250, and then turn the camera in its nodal point to 180 degrees to shoot the second half of the sphere. In post-production, we use software like Mystica VR or Mystica Boutique to stitch the front and back into a full 360 or full 3D 360 immersive video. The benefit of shooting like this allows us to use professional lighting to light the actors and actresses. The director and crew can also be in the scene to direct the talents, so it is more director-friendly. In Hollywood, this is almost a requirement instead of asking the full crew to hide in a cage somewhere. Especially when you are working with big-time director or clients who want to see the action in real time. Shooting Nodal also allow us to have the flexibility to combine scenes in post-production. As you see right here, Kitty and I is shooting in different time doing the same jumping jack. The final Stitch 360 video look like we are actually doing it at the same time and having a full-on conversation. Of course, this requires a very special blocking strategies and some VR directing techniques and experience. I will cover all that in my 360 VR Filmmaking Masterclass. So check out the link on the top right corner for more information. The 60,000 ARRI Alexa Mini LF large format cinema camera is the film industry standard. Doom, The Disney Mandalorian, Stranger Things, and many more Hollywood productions are shot completely on this large format camera. Lots of directors and cinematographers will only shoot on this camera. So making it work in VR is quite necessary. This video is shot on ARRI ProRes MXF instead of the ARRI RAW to save some data. Here is the ungraded log version. The 16-stop dynamic range is something that the current VR camera do not have. Even the upcoming Kendall Obsidian Pro, a $35,000 VR camera, can only do 14-stop in special RAW format. The ARRI post workflow is also very good for video editors. Its RAW format or ProRes MXF files can all be easily playback in all major NLE, including Adobe Premiere and DaVinci Resolve, in both PC or Mac. Compared to Instar 360 Titan H.265 10-bit RAW or Kendall Obsidian Pro RAW, the workflow of using ARRI is a lot faster and very standardized. Something that post-production house will understand and not charging you arms and legs to finish your film. Shooting Nodal and stitching Nodal 360 footage require a very specialty knowledge. I will cover all of that in my upcoming lesson on Creator Up right here and on my 360 VR Filmmaking Masterclass. ARRI Alexa Mini LF is very expensive, but I will use Sony Alpha 1 or Sony A7 series, a full frame mirrorless cameras, to do this Nodal 360 tutorial. The workflow is exactly the same as ARRI Mini LF or Red Monster. So if you are new here to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell here to keep up to date. More and more clients require professional level 360 VR production in the post-pandemic world, and you don't want to fall behind. If you are a traditional 2D cinematographer, there is nowhere better to start learning VR filmmaking and VR storytelling than Kiira Up. So go check out our more dedicated VR filmmaking masterclass right here. Maya Angelou famously said, "People will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you make them feel." The ability to make your audience feel love or hate, joy or despair, fear or enjoyment had never been more at our fingertips than now with virtual reality 360 storytelling. If you have ever wondered how to make a film, documentary or fictional piece using this new medium that creates an emotional impact, a feeling that they will never forget, then please come join me as it is my mission to give you this power to touch, to inspire, and to create. In this 360 VR Filmmaking Masterclass, we will give you a framework to work from as a storyteller or filmmakers using your familiar language. No matter what your skill level is in immersive production, you can take away a wealth of knowledge from some of the world leading experts in the field. We will cover practical topics like fundraising, client communication, budgeting, scripting and storyboarding, directing, blocking, set and space design, camera and shooting, lighting, spatial audio, DIT, stitching, and editing, and even distribution in the entire VR filmmaking ecosystem. I hope this course will serve as your go-to guide on VR filmmaking, so you can go out there and create. No matter if you are a VR producer, director, camera operator, or VR enthusiast.